Good evening, you're watching the news from Bahrain Television. I'm Mary Claire. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sikhir Palace today. His representative for charity work and youth affairs, chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and president of the Bahrain Olympics Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, who introduced to His Majesty the participants of the 8th International Youth Conference. The conference, which includes around 1,600 participants from 32 countries, is organized by the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs under the slogan Success Before 30. After verses of the Holy Quran, His Majesty the King delivered a speech.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صاحب السمو الابن العزيز الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثلنا للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعادة المشاركين والمشاركات في أعمال مؤتمر الشباب الدولي الأعزاء السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته في بلد السلام ومهد الحضارات العريقة مملكة البحرين مرحبين بكم في هذا اليوم ضيوف كرام ومشاركين لكم قاية النماء والنجاح والتطلع إلى مستقبل مشرق تصنعه عزيمتكم وحماسكم للتطوير الذي هو سنة الحياة ومصدر قوتها فأهلا وسهلا بكم في داركم لقد ذكر سمو الشيخ ناصر في حديثه معكم عن أهمية البيئة ودور التربية في تشكيل الفكر الإيجابي واكتساب المهارات والصفات اللازمة للوصول إلى مستويات جديدة من النجاح المتمثل في القدرة على إلهام الآخرين وتحفيزهم نحو الإنجاز وهنا لا نستطيع أن نقفل دور الأمهات الرائد في تلك التهيئة التربوية السليمة والإعداد المطلوب لبيئة النجاح فالأم مدرسة إذا أعددتها أعددت شعبا طيب الأعراق وأحيي في هذا السياق جهود المربية الفاضلة السيدة عائشة عبد الكريم الفائزة بجائزة الأم المثالية في المهرجان الدولي الثالث الذي أقيم مؤخراً بجمهورية مصر العربية التي استطاعت كأم مثالية أن تتحدى صعوبات الحياة وتحويلها إلى قصة نجاح ملهمة لم تقتصر على عائلتها الصغيرة بل امتدت لتشمل أجيالاً من الأبناء كونها مديرة قديرة لأحد مدارس البحرين وختاماً نكرر ترحيبنا بكم ونشكر لكم حرصكم على التعريف بتجاربكم الواعدة ونقل خبراتكم القيمة مع أملنا بأن تتواصل نجاحاتكم وأن يكون تواجدكم في البحرين فرصة طيبة للتعرف على إنجازات شبابنا في المجالات الرياضية والإنسانية والعلمية والثقافية والاقتصادية والتجارية، والذين نكن لهم كل التقدير والاعتزاز بما يبذلون لرفع مكانة البحرين وجعل رقيها هدفاً أسمى في مسيرة نجاحهم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
يلقي سعادة السيد هشام بن محمد الجودر وزير شؤون الرياضة والشباب
Minister of Youth and Sports Hisham Al-Jadr then delivered a speech during the meeting in which he thanked His Majesty the King for his constant support to the younger generation. He said the youth conference hosts many international and successful speakers who inspire the youth to work for their future and achieve success, and highlighted that Bahrain has become an attraction point for those interested in youth affairs, as Manama was the first capital for Arab youth, and it has hosted many youth gatherings, conferences and awards. Minister Al-Jadr commended the leadership of His Majesty the King and his reform project, which turned Bahrain into a modern state that has made the younger generation a cornerstone of its development. He pledged to His Majesty to exert more efforts in service of the country to further develop the state of the youth and reflect the urban image of the kingdom.
شباب البحرين شهد أول ملامح الاهتمام بهم عند تأسيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة في 25 من مارس من عام 1975، وكنتم يا صاحب الجلالة أول رئيس له لتضع الأساسات واللبنات لعمل شبابي ورياضي يرقى بالطموحات المنشودة للمملكة وشبابها. شباب البحرين حظى بإشراكه كعنصر مهم في بناء الدولة الديمقراطية التي أسستم دعائمها يا صاحب الجلالة من خلال إشراكه في صنع القرار وحصوله على حق التصويت والانتخاب، وحظى بتمكيني وإشراكه في قيادة مؤسسات الدولة من خلال توليه المناصب القيادية المختلفة. شباب البحرين حظى بحرية التعبير عن رأيه من خلال إشراكه في اللقاءات الحوارية والتشاورية والمنتديات، وحظى بثقة ودعم جلالتكم، فأصبح سفيراً يمثل بلده في المحافل الشبابية والرياضية. شباب البحرين يرى سفينة تبحر بفضل توجيهات واهتمام جلالتكم بقيادة ربانها سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة ممثل جلالتكم للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة، لترسو بها خليجياً وعربياً وعالمياً. ففي عهد جلالتكم حفظكم الله ورعاكم أصبحت البحرين مقصداً للمهتمين بالشأن الشبابي للإطلاع على تجاربها الناجحة المتميزة، وتوجت المنامة كأول عاصمة للشباب العربي، وأصبحت مركزاً لاستضافة وإقامة العديد من الملتقيات والمؤتمرات الشبابية والجوائز العالمية، لتصبح بذلك حاضنة للشباب من مختلف دول العالم. في عهد جلالتكم شهد الشباب أجمل أيامه وركب سفينة البناء والتطوير، وشارك في عملية التنمية والرخاء، وأصبح رقماً صعباً يشارك بكل ثقة واقتدار في بناء الدولة الحديثة التي أسستم لها يا صاحب الجلالة مشروعكم الإصلاحي الذي شهد له العالم أجمع، وأصبح الشاب جزءاً من معادلة التغيير الأفضل. في عهد جلالتكم شهد العالم دور جلالتكم البارز في دعم قضايا الشباب في مختلف شؤونه، ووصل صداه لشرق الأرض وغربها. هذا الاهتمام بالفئة العمرية التي يصل عددها أكثر من مليار نسمة، أي ما يعادل سدس سكان العالم، هو إيمان من جلالتكم بأنهم هم الأمل الذي تستند عليه جميع الأمم في بنائها ورقيها ونمائها. في الختام نعاهدكم يا صاحب الجلالة ببذل المزيد من الجهد والعطاء مقتدين بنهج جلالتكم، ورؤاكم التي تشكل لنا خارطة الطريق ونبراساً نسير عليه في سبيل رفعة الشباب وعكس الصورة الحضارية عن مملكة البحرين الغالية. دمتم يا صاحب الجلالة في رعاية الله، وأدام الله عليكم موفور الصحة والعافية، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الكلمة الآن لممثل الشباب العربي يلقيها علي عمران الشامسي من دولة الإمارات العربية المتحدة الشقيقة.
delivered a speech expressing pleasure in meeting with His Majesty the King. He said Bahrain is an outstanding model in the region for sustainable development, saying that the youth appreciate His Majesty the King's support and communication to encourage the younger generation. He said the International Youth Conference is an excellent initiative that allows youth to meet with international inspirational speakers to give the youth a map for success. On behalf of the participants of the conference, Al-Shams expressed thanks and gratitude to His Majesty for meeting with them, wishing His Majesty the King continued health and for Bahrain and its people further progress and prosperity.
التي وضعت مملكة البحرين في مصاف الدول المتقدمة في كافة النواحي. جلالة الملك المفدى، نحن شباب العالم نؤمن إيمانا عميقا بأن حرص جلالتكم نصب دوما على لقاء الشباب البحريني والعالمي بصورة مستمرة ومحاورة الشباب والتوجه إليهم لكي يستلهموا من عزبكم ومن طموحاتكم ما يحفزهم على بذل المزيد من الجهود في سبيل الوصول إلى ما يصبون إليه في سبيل الإنجاز والنجاح والاستعداد للمستقبل الواعد. إننا نرى في المؤتمر الشباب الدولي الذي تستضيفه مملكة البحرين مبادرة رائعة قامت بها حكومتكم الجليلة تجاه الشباب العربي، والتي أتاحت لهم الفرصة الكافية للالتقاء بعدد من الملهمين العالميين الذين يملكون قصص نجاح كبيرة ومتميزة على المستوى العالمي، وستعطي الشباب الفرصة للاقتداء بهم ليرسموا خارطة طريق للنجاح لهم. لقد تشرفنا بسماع أولى القصص الناجحة على المستوى العالمي، وهي قصة سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة التي كانت رائعة وملهمة، ويمكن استخلاص أفكار طريق النجاح منها ليضع الشباب أقدامهم على الطريق الموصل للنجاح. إننا نعلم يا صاحب الجلالة أن الشباب يواجهون مسؤوليات وتحديات من نوع خاص، فهم ابتداء القطاع الأوسع في العالم، وهم من سيعيش ومن سيجني عوائد العملية التنموية التي يمر بها العالم اليوم. وإننا بفضل دعم ومساندة جلالتكم سنصل إلى تحقيق أحلامنا، وما هذا المؤتمر إلا تنفيذاً لرؤية جلالتكم في استضافة نخبة من الشباب العالميين للتلاقي على أرض مملكة البحرين الحبيبة، والاطلاع على التجارب الناجحة التي تحفز الشباب على الإبداع وحشد هممهم وطاقاتهم الكامنة ليكتبوا حكاية النجاح الخاصة بهم. وفي الختام أتقدم باسم الشباب المشاركين في المؤتمر بخالص الشكر وعظيم الامتنان على استقبال جلالتكم للشباب العالمي ومنحهم شرف اللقاء بكم، وندعو الله أن يديم عليكم وفور الصحة والعافية ويحفظ البحرين ملكا وحكومة وشعبا من كل شر. والسلام عليكم.
والآن مع كلمة الممثل عن الدول الأجنبية.
Representative of foreign countries Rito Savi then delivered a speech.
Your Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, King of Bahrain, Assalamu alaikum. Good evening. It is indeed a matter of immense honor to be standing in front of Your Majesty on behalf of my fellow youth delegates from all over the world. I wish to extend my gratitude and utmost appreciation for the generous and warm hospitality that we have been offered by our second home, the Kingdom of Bahrain. The Kingdom has been and still remains an oasis of giving and a great example in the region for sustainable development. A result of the wise vision by Your Majesty, which placed the Kingdom of Bahrain in the ranks of advanced countries in all respects. Your Majesty, As the youth of the world, we admire your proactive approach of constantly promoting the exchange between the youth of the kingdom and that of the world. Your passion, determination, and goodwill act as a source of inspiration that will help the youth to work even harder to achieve their goals and prepare for a promising future. The International Youth Conference, hosted by the Kingdom of Bahrain, is a great initiative by the Kingdom's government towards the youth of the world. A platform for us to encounter inspirational international and regional speakers and learn from their success stories to enable us to pave our way to success before 30. It was indeed a matter of privilege to discover the story of His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa to kick off the conference. His speech ignited the spark and gave useful skills to develop to be able to become successful. Being the members of a broader sector of the world, the youth undoubtedly becomes responsible of gets responsibilities and challenges with respect to the development process. Your Majesty, the support provided is highly beneficial in fulfilling these goals. This conference that welcomes the youth of the world in the Kingdom of Bahrain enables an exchange of experiences, culture, and success stories that acts as a catalyst to motivate us to start writing our own story. On this note, allow me to, on behalf of the youth of the world, to share that we have been sincerely grateful for the conference and for providing us the pleasure on meeting you. May God protect you and your kingdom. Shukran.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa then greeted the audience of the 8th International Youth Conference and wished them every success during their participation in the conference. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, met today at Qudaybiyah Palace with a number of diplomatic missions leaders from brotherly and friendly countries, led by Ambassador of Kuwait to Bahrain and Dean of the Diplomatic Corps, Sheikh Azam Mubarak Al Sabah. The Prime Minister affirmed the importance of Gulf, Arab and international cooperation amid ongoing conflicts and tensions that threaten the world's security and its economic development. He highlighted the initiatives that have reinforced the Arab and Islamic status, including the North Thunder military drill launched by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, which reflected a unified stance in dealing with interference in Arab affairs, as well as handling terrorist threats. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister confirmed that the world today is going through unprecedented tension on the security and economic levels, which requires caution in order to protect the people. He pointed out Bahrain's support to all efforts supporting regional stability and peace, which is reflected by the government's approach of focusing on development to achieve the aspirations of the people of the Gulf and Arab region. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, met today with Editor-in-Chief of the Kuwaiti Al Siyasa newspaper, Ahmed Al Jar. The Prime Minister noted the role of the Kuwaiti press, including Al Siyasa newspaper, in the Gulf and Arab journalistic scene, and lauded its role in shedding light on the developmental efforts of the Gulf Cooperation Council countries, including Bahrain, in addition to its support to all endeavours to enhance Arab cooperation in the political, economic and social fields. His Royal Highness expressed gratitude to Mr. Al Jar for his pioneering role in the development of Kuwaiti journalism and commended the deep-rooted relations between Bahrain and Kuwait, considered a model for advanced bilateral relations. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received today at Qudaybiyah Palace a delegation from the Arab Women Investors Union, led by Chairman Dr. Huda Jalal, who presented to His Royal Highness a document for patronising the Arab-African Initiative to support economic bloc. His Royal Highness welcomed the delegation and stressed Bahrain's keenness to nurture and support Arab investments. The Arab Women Investors Union chairman praised the role of His Royal Highness in achieving economic and social progress in Bahrain and Arab region. He lauded the role of the Arab Women's Investor Union and affirmed the government's keenness to support all initiatives that enhance the investment and commercial sectors, along with enhancing Arab cooperation. His Royal Highness affirmed that Bahraini women are strategic partners in the political, economic and social progress of Bahrain and lauded their role in serving the national economy, stressing Bahrain's progress march would continue to provide the best for the country and its people. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, received business figures from Colombia and stressed Bahrain's keenness to enhance cooperation and strengthen relations with all countries in all sectors, especially the business sector. The Colombian delegation praised the role of His Royal Highness in achieving economic and commercial progress for Bahrain, saying that His Royal Highness is a successful role model. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister affirmed the importance of international commercial cooperation, especially when confronted with challenges, threats and terrorist acts, and said the world is aware of the importance of cooperation under the dangers threatening the security and stability of countries. He stressed Bahrain's keenness to cooperate with all countries in order to achieve the prosperous future, adding the government's keenness to strengthen Bahrain's economy in order to achieve regional and international cooperation. The Colombian delegation expressed admiration of the progress and prosperity of Bahrain, which reflects the success of the plans of the government. BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa attended today a shooting drill with live ammunition carried out by the Royal Bahrain Air Defence. On arrival, he was received by the Commander of the Royal Bahraini Air Defence and a number of officers and was briefed on the shooting course and the weapons of the drill. The BDF Commander-in-Chief stressed the importance of the field training and its role in developing the combat skills. He also lauded the good results achieved through field shooting and said the shooting falls within the framework of the programs and plans that aim to raise combat readiness and develop defense capabilities. The Supreme Judicial Council, in cooperation with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, organized a discussion session with a number of accredited ambassadors to the Kingdom, in which they reviewed the strategic development of the Council between 2013 and 2016. Assistant Secretary General of the Supreme Judicial Council, Khalifa Al-Wardi, briefed the attendees on the services provided by the Council, in addition to the strategies adopted regarding judicial training. Speaker of the Representatives' Council Ahmed Al-Mulla chaired the weekly meeting today, where the Council approved a report on anti-unemployment insurance. The Council also approved another report on elections of members of the municipal councils and then referred a proposal on extensions and renewals of housing applications for BDF officers and soldiers participating in Operation Decisive Storm in Yemen to concerned committee. The Council also approved issuing a statement on the terrorist act in Iraq to provide them with the support needed and combat terrorism. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, deputised Cabinet Affairs Minister Mohammed bin Ibrahim Al Mutawa to attend the opening of the 27th Arab Engineering Conference themed Transportation in the Arab World and the Prospects for its Development and Integration Between Arab Countries, organised by the Bahrain Society of Engineers, the BSE, in collaboration with the Federation of Arab Engineers and the presence of 350 participants from various Arab countries. Al-Mutawa conveyed the greetings of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to the participants and his wishes for every success to the conference in order to come up with the results that would develop the transportation sector in the Arab world to serve Arab economies, boost growth rates and increase the trade volume among Arab countries. He also affirmed that His Royal Highness's patronage of the event embodies his interest in boosting exhibitions and conferences industry, being an important tributary to the national economy and enhancing the Kingdom's distinguished regional status in this regard. The minister highlighted the importance of the conference in providing a platform for Arab engineers to meet and share experiences and opinions about the future of the transportation sector. He also called for providing more budgets and launching investments to develop the infrastructure of the Arab transportation sector, to link Arab countries and facilitate the flow of trade between them. He expressed hope that the conference will contribute to developing a long-term strategy that meets the needs of the transportation sector in the Arab world.